So hey everyone, welcome everyone. So we're here for the Appruve webinar. Appruve is, you know, their identity verification company. They have two products, Appruve Identity and Appruve Agency. So that's what we are here for. They're here to introduce us to those two products. I don't take too much time. I think on the webinar with me is Laud Bruce Tagoe of Appruve, and he's gonna walk us through everything. Tell us what it's about and demo it for us, and then after we take a few questions. So Laud, straight into it.
Okay. Anyways, thanks guys for joining us. My name is Laud. I'm the CTO at Appruve. I'll be taking you through this webinar session. It's a very practical session. Before we go through the session itself, I'm going to introduce you to Appruve and the products that we have on offer. Now, if you have any questions, you can probably type it out. I'm sure Anthony can read out, then I'll answer those questions. So Appruve is a set of
Laud, just a minute. So let me walk you through. So at the bottom right of your screen, you see ask a question. You can click on that and ask your question, and then others can vote on it, and then I'll pick up one or two during the session, and then after Laud is done, we'll go through the rest. So how about
it? Okay, thank you. So Appruve essentially provides APIs to help verify the financial identities of individuals and businesses across Africa. And so with Appruve, we have two main products on the market now. We have Appruve Identity and also Appruve Agency. I'll talk a bit about what Appruve Identity is and then what Appruve Agency is also. Now, Appruve Identity is essentially an API that allows you to verify the ID documents of individuals across in four markets that we are in right now. So these are government-issued ID cards. That's for Ghana, Kenya, Nigeria, and also for Uganda. We're able to verify ID types like national IDs, voter IDs, tax identification numbers, business registries, driver licenses, and then in the case of Nigeria, the bank verification number. So like I said, we are able to do this for Ghana, Kenya, Nigeria, and then for Uganda. Appruve Agency
Hi, Laud. Laud, you got muted.
Yes.
Yeah, so come again. You got muted for... Yeah.
Oh, okay. So let me probably take the Appruve Identity again. Can you hear me?
Loud and clear. Loud and clear. Go on.
Cool. So Appruve Identity, just to reiterate, is an API that allows you to verify the ID documents of users across four markets that we are in right now. That's for Ghana, Kenya, Nigeria, and also for Uganda. We're able to verify the documents for national IDs, voter IDs, tax identification numbers, business registries, driver licenses, and then in the case of Nigeria, the bank verification number. So Appruve Identity is basically an API that allows you to verify a government-issued ID card. Appruve Agency is basically an add-on to Appruve Identity, which provides OCR functionality. So Appruve Agency, with Appruve Agency, you can do an OCR on an ID document, basically extract the PII details on the ID card document. Appruve Agency also does liveness checks to make sure the individual sitting behind the camera is indeed like an individual and not any other object. Appruve Agency also allows you to basically match the face on, let's say, the ID card document to their face on a particular selfie image. So if it's a selfie that you allow the user to take, we are able to match the selfie image or the face on a selfie to the face on the ID card document. So that's Appruve Agency, and that's what it does. And like I said, in combination with Appruve Identity, these are the two solutions that Appruve has on the market right now.
Okay, great.
So I'm going to take you through how Appruve works, but to be able to do this, I'm going to take you through basically creating an account in Appruve, and I'll walk you through how to start get started on Appruve. So I'm going to switch to my browser here. Then this is our website, Appruve.co. If you want to sign up, you basically log on to Appruve.co. If you're a new user, you click on this button, the login button, but you have a login link, sorry, a sign up link. You click on the sign up link. It presents you with a form. Basically, you put in your profile data and then your business data. For the purpose of this demo, I'm going to use a different link. It's pretty much the same thing, but I'm going to switch over to this form. So basically enter my bio data. Then I'm going to enter my business information. Select my role as the person who's signing up. Then I'm going to sign up to like a host of services. So Appruve Agency and Appruve Identity are the two products that we have on the market, but we also have Appruve Income and Appruve Diligence, which are two products that we'll be launching soon. We'll talk about them briefly later on in the presentation. So we submit. Now, for the purpose of this demo, I'm not going to verify. Typically, when you sign up, you have to confirm your email before you are able to log back into your dashboard. So this is your Appruve dashboard. As a developer or as an engineer, when you sign up, this is what you see. And one of the first things you can do to start, you know, working with Appruve is to create an access token. So I'm going to head over to the developer section and click on personal access tokens. We don't have any token created yet, so I'm going to generate a new token. Now we are going to first create what we call a test token. Now a test token allows you to basically test IDs which are not live IDs, but it helps you to basically know how Appruve works and how to model, you know, your implementation after the responses that you're going to get from the API. So I'm going to name my token a test token. So you basically provide a descriptive name, select the duration in terms of how long you want this token to be, you know, valid. Then select the scopes that you want to work with. So the scopes basically, basically details what specific permissions the token can have. So we have view verification details, view list of verifications, verify ID documents, and multi-sources verification. I'm going to check all because I want to use this token to do a lot more things than just like verifying the test ID. So basically the scopes that just reiterates basically allows you to indicate what the access token that you are creating, what it can do in terms of the verification. Now, because we are creating a test token here, I'm going to check this box and then click on generate token. Now, for security reasons, we don't store the token that you create. So this token here is shown to you one time. So the recommendation is that it basically treats this token as a password. So you copy it and then store it securely. Now you can always come back and revoke the token if you feel that token is compromised. But then it's very much the onus is on you basically to make sure you secure your token or you keep it in a secure place. So I'm going to copy this token and then close this out. So we just created a test token here. So one of the things you can do, or if you want to work with the Appruve API, is to go to the documentation site. So this is docs.appruve.co. And then we have various endpoints for various products. So this is for Appruve Identity, and then Appruve Agency, and also for Appruve Business. Now, for a test token, you cannot do live verifications. You can only work with test IDs. To see the list of test IDs you can work with, you click on the testing section on the developers subsection you have here. So we have test IDs for Ghana, Kenya, Nigeria, and also for Uganda. For Ghana, these are our test IDs. I'm going to try to test out the passport verification for Ghana. So I've still, just to note that I've copied the test token that we just created. I'm going to head over to Postman and try out the endpoints. So for Ghana verification, the ID document verification, typically this is how our endpoint is structured. So we have the base URL. Note that I'm using a staging URL here. Typically you have api.appruve.cu. For the purpose of this demo, I'm using stage. So this is the base URL. Then you have the version. So this is version one. Then you have the verifications endpoints. Then you have the two-digit country code. So in the case of Ghana, you have GH, Nigeria, NG, Kenya is KE, and then Uganda is UGIN. Then you indicate the type of document you want to verify. So in this case, it's passport. So I'm going to go to the authentication section, the authorization section, and then paste the test token that I just created. Then you basically copy out these test IDs that we have here. And the rest of the details are the same thing here. So let's submit this. So this is the expected response from the API. Basically, the API will verify the PI details that you send. So we have the details that you submitted along with parameters like that's the first name match, or the last name match, middle name match, and then the date of birth as a match. So these are what we are verifying against the government issue database. So we query the database of the government issuer, then we match those details that you sent to us. Then we return you to you the results of the verification. So these are a successful response. Just in case you want to see what an unsuccessful result looks like, I'm going to change this to 3. Then submit again. Then if you are not able to find the matching record, this is the results that we return to you, basically a 404 not found. So essentially this is how you work with the test token on Appruve. If you've done enough testing and you feel like you want to go live, then you create a live personal access token. So let's do that quickly also. Because it's a live token, I'm not going to check the test token. I'm just going to go straight to generate token. Copy. Then I'm going to try out a live verification. So I want to verify a live Nigeria voter ID. So again, the same endpoints, but then the 2-digit country code is NG, and the type of ID is voter. So again, I'm going to paste in the token that I just copied. Then these are live details of a user that I want to verify. So I click on send. Now it says that your approved credits is exhausted. Now for live verifications, you need to have credits to be able to do live verifications. For anybody who signs up and you want to, you know, test some live or do some live verifications, we can issue you some free credits. So you can contact us, and then we'll be able to issue you some free credits. Now, because this user does not have any credits, what I'm going to do is that one of the ways you can also, you know, get credits is basically sign up to one of our plans. I'm going to quickly sign up to our developer plan. It's a $55 five-frame verifications bundle. Okay, after payment is confirmed, you can come back to the product section, go to usage. Then you will notice you've been issued the 500 credits. So I'm going to try out the same verification that failed earlier. And now we have a successful result.
Quickly, can you go back to the payments page? I think I saw something like monthly verification checks. Okay, does that mean it's 500 for the month?
So for a developer plan, actually, it doesn't expire per month, or it's not a subscription for a month. It's basically a one-time payment. Okay. And so once you have your credits, you don't have to pay, you know, $55 per month. It's just a one-time credit to pay, buy.
Okay.
Yeah. Cool. So essentially, that's how Appruve Identity works. Like I said, we can do this for Ghana, Nigeria, Uganda, and then also for Kenya also. So at this stage, I think I'll probably take some questions if there are any questions on the floor.
Yeah, so currently there are no questions, surprisingly. I don't know. Does anyone have any questions? Well, I guess my question will be, do you have postman collections?
Not yet. So we can create a postman collection and share.
Okay. Yeah. But how about developer docs?
Developer docs, you have to work with the docs.approve.co. That's our primary documentation page.
Can you show us that quickly? I think we didn't see that.
So that's actually this docs.approve.co, or if you want to probably see more of a breakdown of how you can work with this on approve.co, we also have a doc section on here. So if you go to, for example, docs quick starts, we give a breakdown of how basically you can create a token and how you can basically get started.
Okay, so we have a few questions. Are all ID types supported for all countries? So for example, can I check passport, voter, whatever, across all the countries? Or are there some countries that maybe might have only passport and voter?
Yes, so traditionally for Ghana and Nigeria, you can do for all the traditional like ID documents, voter, passport, driver license, yeah. But for Kenya, you can only do for national ID and then for the passports. For Uganda is quite peculiar. So for Uganda, what we are able to do now, is actually verify the a telco subscriber details. So for example, if you give us the phone number and then a name, we can do a check on a particular telco network and tell you if that person is registered on that network and then what a verified name on that network, you know, provider is. And basically you can work with that. So that's for in this particular instance, that's for Uganda. So Uganda is more for telco subscription. You want telco subscriber, basically. If you want to verify the telco subscriber details, we can enable that, or we have an endpoint for doing that.
Okay, that's actually something that would be great to have across all the countries. Do you have that for any other country, or is it in the pipeline?
So it's in the pipeline. We are talking with the telcos here.
Okay. So the other question is, do you have SDKs?
Yes, we have mobile SDKs, primarily for Android now. We are working on our iOS version and also the web version. We'll have enough time to take you through how the integration for the mobile SDK works. So we'll take you through that.
Okay. So I think you can move on to agency, the demo, let's see.
Okay, cool. So what I'm going to do is to first, so we've done Appruve Identity, we want to move on to Appruve Agency. Now, Appruve Agency has an SDK, has a mobile SDK that you can integrate. Now, if you're the type that you want to probably get your hands dirty and simply work with the APIs and do your own form of integration, then we also provide the Appruve Agency APIs to work with. Now, the Appruve Agency APIs, you can use that to implement, you know, whatever custom integration you want to do. So what I'm going to demo is basically a web implementation of the Appruve Agency APIs. Then I'll quickly take you through how the mobile SDK integration actually works. So I'm going to switch over to the web implementation of the Appruve Agency APIs. This is a web implementation of the Appruve Agency APIs. I'm going to change, so you can select which country you want like test out for. I'm going to go with Nigeria. I'm going to select the ID document I want to work with. So in this case, I'm going to select voter ID. Then I'm going to click to upload a document. So I'm going to upload a voter ID document. So this is the first stage of the process. So basically an OCR is going to be done on this ID. So the OCR will extract the face on the ID card and then the other PI details. So in this case, the voter ID number, first name, last name, and then the rest of the PI details. I'm going to save this. Then I'm going to upload a selfie image. So at this point, it's probably better to, you know, prompt the user to use their webcam, because that's where you can check liveness and all that. But for the purposes of this demo, I'm just going to submit a selfie photo. So this is the image we're going to use. Then we wait for the results. So essentially, what we do is that anytime you go through the process of using Appruve Agency, we come out with what we call a confidence score. The confidence score is basically the total score of all the checks that we did. So first, we did a face match check, basically checking if the face on the selfie matches the face on the ID card. And then we also do a check against the issuer database to make sure the document data actually exists in the database. So those two scores come up to what we call the confidence score. In this case, the face match score is 90.41. The ID card score is perfect. Like, these are the details that were extracted from the document. this is the image I submitted. It's not a selfie per se, but this is, we just wanted to make sure we have something to work with. So this is the image that was submitted as selfie. And this is the two images that were extracted, the face from the ID card and the face from the selfie. This is the document, the ID document that was submitted itself. And that was what we used to do the OCR. So basically, as a compliance person, if you're signed on to Appruve, any verification that comes through, we are able to break down that verification and tell you the data that came through and how we arrived at the score that we did. And so this is primarily like a web implementation of how, you know, the Appruve Agency works. I'm going to switch over. So like I said, for those of you who probably want to get your hands dirty and they want to see how you can do that at the API level and maybe do some custom integration, I'm going to switch immediately to post one again. Then for the Appruve Agency APIs, the endpoints are a bit different. So in this case, we have the same call URL, but we have selfie image, we have OCR, again, the two-digit country code, and then also the type of ID card that you are submitting as for the OCR. Then the only thing you have to do is to submit the image, the ID card document itself. So that's what we submitted here as a value of ID image. Then we basically submit to the API. So this is the response we're getting from the API. It's pretty much the same that we showed on the web. So it basically extracts the PI details, ID number, first name, last name. It also, you know, sends you a URL of the image that was extracted. Then it sends you a unique transaction reference, which is assigned to every verification that comes through. I'm going to use this transaction reference for the next stage. So after you do the OCR, the next thing you have to do is to submit the selfie image to the server. So the endpoint for doing that is selfie image upload. And basically the payload is basically submit the transaction reference that you got from the OCR stage. And then you also attach the selfie image that you want to use. Then you submit again to the server. Okay, so in this case, the confidence score is quite low. We'll look at that why it is. But basically, some of the details that you return to use, the ID type, the country code, the status, which is failed in this case, the type of verification, the face match percent. Now, let's take a look at the selfie image that we submitted. This is a different image to the one we use on the web. So let's just copy this URL. So this selfie image is quite different from the one that we use. So obviously, these are two separate people. So that is how come the face match percent is quite low. The ID match percent is quite high because it's pretty much a legit ID. But at the end of the day, the confidence score is well below the threshold that we need to be able to classify this as successful. Generally, anything between 90 and 100, we consider it a success. Anything between 80 and 100 is provisional, and anything below 80 is a failed verification. So essentially, this is how you can work with Appruve Agency at the API level. You can use this to do any custom integration. Just a point to note here is that if you are using the API, we won't be able to do liveness check at the API level. So you have to do that at your end. If you are using the mobile SDK, we take care of the liveness feature or the liveness check and be able to determine if the person behind the camera is indeed the person behind the camera. at the API level, we are not able to do that now. It's something that we are working on. Hopefully we can do that, you know, in our next update. So that is pretty much for Appruve Agency at the API level. I'm going to switch over to the mobile SDK, but if you have any questions, we can take questions.
Yeah, so a few questions, some of it around identity, but I think let me take this one for now. So Shahzad, can you ask the question again? It's not too clear. So I think he was asking how the live selfie image is uploaded, if there's an app that scans like a QR code or if it's to be uploaded. I'm not too clear if those are two different questions, how the live selfie is taken and then if the, you have an app that scans a QR code. And then
I'm not sure.
So about that, can you ask this question again? It's not too clear. So
what I can say quickly to that, to the upload part, is that for the upload, you just need to make sure, you know, you take a picture of the of the face in terms of the selfie, of the face of the person sitting behind the PC at that time. And then for the documents, you just have to provide an upload button that the user will just click and upload the document.
Yeah. Okay. So the other one is, do you have any native integrations? For example, Bubble.io?
No. So no, we don't have that. I'm not sure what Bubble.io is though.
Okay, so I think we can check. But you mentioned you have some SDKs for native, both Android and iOS, to come out soon.
Yeah, so we have for Android native and for React Native Android.
Okay, and iOS is coming out soon?
Yeah, iOS is coming out soon.
Okay. So there's a final question, but I'll leave that for later. So I think you can go on.
Okay, cool. So I'm going to switch over to Android Studio. So basically, if you want to work with Appruve Agency.
Just one quick one I think I missed. So do you have credit history? Do you do credit checks? Do you support that?
Sorry, can you ask that again?
Credit checks, credit history. Do you have support for that?
So we are working on a product called Appruve Financial. So Appruve Financial should be able to do that. It's still in the works, and so when it's ready, we'll brief you on that.
Okay, continue.
Cool. So I've switched over to Android Studio. If you want to work with Appruve Mobile SDK for Android, basically this is how the integration works. First thing you have to do is to go to your root level build.gradle, and then you make sure you add this in the Maven URL for Appruve. Now there are sample implementations on GitHub. We can send the links to you, but essentially make sure you add the Maven URL here. That's at your root level build.gradle. Then you go to your app level build.gradle. Then you add the dependency for the Appruve Mobile SDK. Now, once you add that, you basically build your projects, make sure you download the dependencies. Then what you have to do is to probably, you know, target the, you know, the stage at which you want to trigger the verification process. So in this case, I'm going to head to the main activity. Basically, what I've done is to provide a button that says start verification. When the user clicks on that button, then I launch the Appruve Mobile SDK. So the Appruve Mobile SDK has its own set of UIs that it will take the user through. So it will take the user to take a picture of their document, you know, submit, take a picture of their face, submit, then wait for the results. Now, when the user is waiting for the result, or after the results come through, you basically receive a callback in your program, then the callback is a boolean. It's a true or false. So if the user is verified, that means the boolean is true. If it's not verified, that means the boolean is false. And so based on the boolean, you know, value of the callback, you can determine whether you want to move the user to the next process probably maybe the user at that stage is going to do a financial transaction or something. So this is what I'm pretty much doing here. I'm initializing I'm creating an intent for the approve activity, and I'm passing these parameters here. So first is your API token, the one you created from the dashboard. Then you can brand the SDK in your brand color. So you can change the status color, the toolbar color, navigation icon, and all the branding and all the branding that you can think of. You can basically brand it in your brand colors. Then currently we have the SDK enabled for Ghana, Nigeria, and Kenya. So you can decide which ones you want to enable for which particular country. In this case, I think it's only Nigeria and Kenya that are enabled. Then you basically fire the activity, then wait for the results. So when the results comes through, it's going to be true or false, like I said. So based on the result, then you can decide how you want to work with the user, probably move the user to the next stage. Now, I've already built this already. It takes a while, so I won't be able to take you through the entire process. The emulator is quite restrictive when it comes to using the camera, and so I'm just going to show you how the interface looks. So pretty much this is the button that I added for the sample application that I showed you. So when you click on verify your identity, it basically launches the Appruve SDK UI. So this is the home screen for the Appruve Identity SDK. You click on this button. Then because I've enabled for just Nigeria and Kenya, those are the two countries that are shown. I click on Nigeria, the ID types are here. So passport, driver license, voter ID, and the national ID. If I click on passport, it's going to launch the camera. Basically, at this point, says I position your ID card inside the frame and tap. So if I have my ID card, I basically have to position my camera, to the ID card document and make sure, the full circle is inside the frame as shown in the camera. Then I basically click on, the mobile screen. Then it's going to capture the ID card, then process it, and then basically move the user across, the different screens that we have. Now, because this is an emulator, it's difficult to use a camera here. But like I said, it's something that you can basically try it out on your own, basically do the integration that I just showed you using Android Studio, and build your project, then you can be able to work with the Appruve SDK for mobile. So this is for
Lord. So is there documentation on integrating the SDKs?
Yes. So there is a documentation for that. Let me quickly show you guys. Yes, let me see. Yes, so there's a section on Appruve Agency API integration. And
SDK.
Yeah. So the SDK, we have a sample app on GitHub. We can share with you after this presentation. Basically, there are instructions in the README section of the GitHub repo.
Okay. Okay.
And basically you can go through that here.
Okay, continue.
Cool. So that's basically it for Android native. Basically, like I said, just make sure you add the Gradle and the dependency, and make sure just initiate the activity and listen for the callback, and then work with the callback results. We also have the SDK for React Native Android. Like I said, for both platforms, we are still working on the iOS version, and so you can only work with Android for now. For React Native, you basically make sure you add a dependency for the SDK, which is React Native Appruve Mobile SDK. Basically, install your dependency and npm install. Then, like the same thing we did for the Android Studio, basically make sure you have something like a button that the user will click to initiate the process. In this case, we are importing the Appruve Mobile SDK model. Then on button press, we are calling the start verification method. We pass the token and then the brand colors and the country specifically that you are enabling for. And then it returns a promise. And so when a promise is resolved, you get a result, whether it's verified or not. It's verified again, it's Boolean. And so you can work with that. Now, when you build your project, let me open. So this is the sample React Native project. So basically the same button, start verification, and it basically starts the same, the same mobile SDK UI that I showed for React Native. So it's pretty much works the same thing. This, for these, all the countries are enabled. So it basically shows you the all the countries then. You can work through that same thing as the other screens also. So this is how you can work with the mobile SDKs. They are pretty straightforward. All you have to do is install the dependencies and make sure you have a button, you know, listener, click listener, that you can use to fire the start verification process. Then you listen for the callback results. Then you can work with the callback results. So it's pretty much straightforward. That's it for the mobile SDK section. Like I said, we have sample apps on GitHub. We will share with you. If you want to take a look at that, you can take a look at the sample implementation. Then you can work with that. So at this point, I think we have some few minutes left. We can dedicate the rest of the time for questions.
Okay, so are you done with the slides? Have you run us through all the slides you have?
Yes, so these are our support channels. So if you want to reach out to us, these are, you know, links you can take notes of, then reach out to us. Then we also have a community page on Slack you can join. And also join that also. So we can take questions now.
Okay. So there was one question. You know, there were two other products that you selected aside Identity and Agency. Can you walk us through them?
Yes, so we have aside Appruve Identity and Appruve Agency, we also have Appruve Diligence. Appruve Diligence basically allows you to do due diligence on individuals and businesses across Africa. Like I said, that is a product that is being worked on currently, and so basically it probably asks you to just enter the business registration details of a business. Then we can tell you, you know, more details of the business so that probably if you want to go ahead and work with a business in any capacity, you know, you are working with a verified business. So that's for Appruve Diligence. Now, Appruve Financial, the other products, basically, like one of you guys said, if you want to obtain credit history of an individual, basically, that's one of the things that Appruve Financial can do. Basically, it's going to connect the identity of an individual to multiple financial data sources, including, let's say, mobile money, including bank accounts. And so basically, it helps you to basically consolidate this data and make it like very useful to whoever is requesting for that information or whoever wants to use that information. And so that's for Appruve Diligence, and it's also for Appruve Financial.
Okay, are there any other products coming up?
Those are the two current ones that we're currently working on.
Okay. So your SDKs, are they open source?
So they are not open source. They, like I said, what we have is a sample implementations on GitHub, but they are not open source.
Okay. So with regard to, I have a question. So with regards to the identity, for example, do you also have any? Okay, well, I guess you answered that, but my question was, if you had something for, you know, screening against sanctions lists and terrorist databases and the likes, blacklisted people and so on.
Yeah, so that's one of the things that we intend to achieve using Appruve Financial. And so, yeah, so that's one of the things. We are talking with some of the fintech or the payments firms who basically have these lists. So make sure like we're able to consolidate and make sure like, you know, we harmonize this data, and anybody who wants to have access to, you know, data concerning a business, we can okay. easily provide that via one single API.
Okay. So you were saying, you know, anywhere from 90 to 100 is considered a match.
Yes.
Anywhere below what, 80 is, it's a failure. You shouldn't proceed. But
yes.
Anywhere between 80 and 90 is provisional. What does that mean?
So provisional means that we cannot say that you are verified. At the same time, we cannot say that you failed. The reason being that it's possible that you might have a legit, let's say, ID document. That maybe the document is probably a bit faded. And so when we're probably trying to match the image on the document, the image on the selfie, the score was a bit low. So when it comes to that, we just flag it as provisional. What will happen is that when a compliance officer logs into the dashboard and they have, you know, access to the list of verifications, now they can manually approve that particular verification as successful if they go through the data sources that, or the data that came through, and they can manually verify that. I think that it was just because maybe the document was blurry or something, but I think this is the person, you know, the person in the picture is actually the person who is actually doing the verification. And so provisional means that there has to be some manual check on that before you can be approved as verified.
Okay, right. Okay, now with regards to, you know, the credits, I guess it's one credit per check, correct?
Yes, it's one credit per check. Yeah, that's for Appruve Identity though. If you are doing Appruve Agency, it's more than one, but we can talk about that later on. But right. If you're doing for Appruve Identity, it's basically one credit per one verification for successful verifications.
For successful. Okay, so if you fail, you are not billed.
Yes, for the Appruve Identity. That's for Appruve Identity. Yeah.
Identity. How about if, let's say, I verify the same ID twice? Is that two credits?
Yes. No. So so any kind of check that you do, once it's successful, because we are also being what you call, we are also being charged per successful what you call.
Check.
And so once you do any subsequent one, you still be charged.
Okay. When you're creating the token, right, you checked, you know, some permissions. What happens if you don't check a permission by us trying to use the token for that?
Yeah, so you receive an error that tells you don't have enough scopes for the kind of verification that you're trying to do. So that's why it's important that you check what you call. So if you just want a token, that probably will allow you to release verifications. Then maybe you can just check the list verification scope. But if you want to do verification, make sure you check the verification scope. And if you want to do the same token for both Appruve Identity and Appruve Agency, you make sure you check the multi-source verification.
But the you know, any error messages will be descriptive enough to, you know, just guide you to what you are supposed to do.
Yes. Okay. Yes.
But what happens if you use a test token, like a test token for live, like, how, what are the differences between those?
So for test tokens, basically what we are doing is that we have a list of IDs that we check against. And so if you use a test token and you are using live details, I mean, those live details, when we check, we won't find like a match against them. So it's just going to return 404.
Okay, right.
Yeah, it's
right.
Just going to return 404, yeah.
Okay, I think we have just about 5 minutes to go. Guys, is there any question? I think we can probably take just about one more question if anyone else has. Well, I think everyone is cool. I think the presentation was clear, the demos. For now, we need to just go back and play around with these things and we'll get an idea of. Okay, so someone is asking support channels, and then I also want to know, you mentioned you can get, we can reach out to get credits. So yes. How do we do?
I don't know whether Paul can facilitate that. So Paul can probably share their links. Then maybe what we can do is that you should take, you know, your emails that you're going to need to sign up. Then maybe what we can do is that we can pre-fill, you know, that accounts with, you know, free credits, so that when you register, you already have the free credits.
Okay. I think, Paul, can you, you know, in the chat link, can you just drop, you know, all the relevant links? And then you mentioned Slack, the website, the documentation, the samples on GitHub. If you just drop them into the chat, that would be great.
Yeah.
Yes, I think this is great. This was awesome. Right now with Charlie, social distancing and stuff. It looks like we can use this to, you know, you can sign up new users, take their pictures, verify their ID, check liveness and all without meeting them. So this is awesome. It's coming out at the right time, yeah?
Definitely.
So I think thanks so much for making the time and for having us. This was a great and a very informative session. Like you said, all the support links, everything will be shared. So guys, feel free to reach out and try it, test it, sign up, you know, for a demo. Let's get some feedback and let's integrate and build on some things. Yeah. Thanks also, Paul. Thanks, Laud. And this has been Tony, your host and moderator. Over and out. When you call my name, it feels like paradise in heaven.